Why do I see lots of failed login attempts on my account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question we got. I was changing my password tonight on Hotmail and went into a section I've never noticed before called Recent Activity. I was shocked to see that in the past 2 weeks there were a ton of failed attempts from nearly every country on the map that had tried to log into my Hotmail account. Is this normal? Should I be scared? Should I close the account? I've had this account since 1997, so it has lots of information about me in different folders. Thanks. My Hotmail account is probably just as old. And it has the same thing. I'll show you what that is, where it is, and why it's honestly not much to be worried about. The big takeaway, I think, that a lot of people don't realize is that every account, be it Hotmail, Gmail, online services, servers, etc., we are all under constant attack. It's a slow, persistent, 24 hours, 7 days a week kind of attack where hackers are, well, actually their bots are trying different usernames with known passwords, not necessarily associated with those usernames, but passwords that have been discovered, and just sort of slowly trying them against all these different services across the internet. And that includes your email account and my email account. So let me show you what that looks like, and we'll talk about why it's not really as much of an issue as you might be concerned about. So here we are. This is my Outlook account, or an Outlook account, my example Outlook account in Windows 11. And you can see, of course, there's, you know, the inbox and so forth. If we go to account.live.com/activity, we will see what we're talking about. Wants me, of course, to sign in again to make sure that I am who I say I am. And there we are. And sure enough, there's some recent activity. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and hit view more account activity a couple of times so that we can see. So, indeed, approximate location, United States. Great. That's me. I am the recent activity. However, these others are interesting. Two of them from Germany. Should I be worried? No. And here's why. If we expand each of these, we'll see that it's an unsuccessful sync. Or in this case, these are SMTP attempts, right? It's attempting to use a desktop email program to access email from this email address. They're not able to do it, either because they don't know the password or they don't have the correct two-factor or whatever. Same thing as we go down to, gosh, these guys have been at it for a while, right? This is all from Germany. Again, a slow, persistent bot. And then below that is yesterday at 10:30 a.m., a couple or at least one unsuccessful sign-in attempt, again from Germany, to this email address, but incorrect password entered. For each of these situations, the only thing they need to know, and in fact the only thing they have, is my email address. Well, that's not private knowledge. Email addresses are almost by definition public. So again, what these botnets are doing is they're taking email addresses that they've discovered and using databases of passwords that have been discovered elsewhere and just very slowly, very persistently trying to sign in. And here's the thing. It doesn't really cost them anything to do this. And it doesn't take much return on their investment for it to be profitable. They might try a million different accounts. If they break into one, it's a success. How do they break in? Typically, this is the scenario that will bite you if you are reusing passwords. In other words, a password that you use in multiple places has been discovered in a breach because one of those places got breached. All those other places now are at risk of this happening. Maybe not today, maybe not this month, but eventually, they might get around to your email address and that password you reused from the past. So, what do you do? Honestly, there's nothing to be done here other than the stuff you should be doing anyway. Secure your account. Do all the things you already know to have a good, strong, and most importantly, unique password for every account. Consider adding two-factor authentication. That way, even if they know the password, their sign-in will fail. But the bottom line here is that honestly, this isn't really anything to be too concerned about as long as your account is appropriately secure. And while I have your attention on that matter, please make sure that your recovery information is up to date, that recovery email address, that recovery phone number, whatever it is that you would use to regain access to your account if anything ever went wrong. That's critical as well. Anyway, hope that sets your mind at ease. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/14543. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.